Colorado counties say their jails are just falling apart. Now, sheriffs are asking for the state to help them after voters rejected that tax hike that would have paid for improvements.
As Denver 7's Lance Hernandez shows us today, a top Colorado official saw firsthand what needs to be done.
You search for drugs also, I assume.
Lieutenant Governor Diane Primavera learning about the challenges faced by big county jails. Arapahoe County is now 33 years old. It was built in 1986 and is showing its age.
With a capacity of 386 inmates, this was probably appropriately sized for that population level.
Today, the jail is housing 1,100 people, 40% of which deal with mental health issues.
We don't have the space to provide group therapy.
Voters turned down a proposal to build a new jail. The SO's administrative manager says they still have to do something because the lack of space is creating risk
for officer safety, staff safety, other inmate safety as well.
I asked if the state can help jails deal with overcrowding related to medical and mental health issues.
One of our big goals is to try and keep them out of the criminal justice system in the first place.
Primavera says the focus is on mental health and continuity of care. She lauded Arapahoe County for pioneering a new medication consistency pilot program, getting up-to-date medical records in real time.
I talked to a family once and they had a loved one in jail and they wanted to bring the medication in because he was schizophrenic, and of course the jails wouldn't let him do that.
Anderson says the sheriff's office isn't giving up its hope for help.
It's important for us to let our challenges be known. I also think it's important for people to understand that correctional health care is a public safety and a public health issue, and we do have to get that addressed.
Lance Hernandez, Denver 7.
A measure to fund a new jail in Arapahoe County was defeated handily last November. In fact, 2/3 of the voters said no.